last day of action from the 2015 Winter Universiade. We've had a fabulous 11 days of action on snow and ice in Andalusia. More medals up for grabs in the short track. Relays for the men in the 5,000 metres and women's 3,000 metres. There was a curling final between Norway and Russia, looking for a double gold. And in ice hockey, the Czech Republic and Kazakhstan going head-to-head for a place in the final. Been a spectacular week of action at the Igloo for the short track event at the Universiade. Last day saw the relays, the women going in the 3,000 metres. Four teams going: China, South Korea, Canada and Japan. The champions were South Korea. Could they retain the title that they won in Italy 2 years ago? These are starting competitors then for China. Look out for Yu Tong Han, the 500 metre champion in the individual. Also got a bronze medal in the 1500 metres. She was a real candidate, kicking things off for China. Incidentally, the B final, earlier won by Russia ahead of the USA and Ukraine. This was the big one. China, Yu Tong Han, their star skater. Xu Ji, also there from the Harbin Sports University. And Hong Li and Meng Lin, also from the same university. Yu Han, the number six for China. Defending champions, Alan Kim, remember the 1,000 and 1,500 metre champion. Going with Eunbo Li, the 1,000 and 1,500 metre silver champion this week. Arum No and Hakyung Son also going. Son, the 500 metre silver. That was why they were favourites. But this would prove to be a wonderful battle. Canada going well as well with Joni Gervais from the University of Quebec. Namaste Harris Gautier from the College of Maisonneuve. Kerry Morrison from the University of Calgary. Carolyn Truchot from the University of Quebec. The handover is so important, of course. Kim Lang from the Korean National Sports University won a relay gold in Sochi. Silver last year's Worlds in Montreal. Eunbo Li, 1,000 metre silver at the 2013 Universiade. 1,500 silver at the Vancouver Olympics. So some real quality candidates. Number nine there was Meng Lin getting the push. And China would really show some good teamwork here. Three of them from Harbin University know each other really well, and that showed, frankly. Hakyung Song, number 22 for Korea, 500 metre silver medalist, into the business end of this 3,000 metre event. It was always going to be between China and South Korea, but who would have the stronger legs at the end? Number six is Han for China. Putting in a really good skate. It was a tight 100 metre circuit, and she did enough. Yu Tong Han, what a week it's been for her. Champion with the 500 metres, bronze in the 1500, and a gold medal with her team, China winning the gold medal. Han, Ji, Lee and Lin. Korea second, Canada getting a good bronze. The winning time 4:19.010 for the Chinese. South Korea a little disappointed with a silver. Canada make the long journey home with a bronze. The men's competition finishing off with a 5,000 metre relay. China, Russia, France and Japan in action. The champions Hungary not present, and neither was South Korea, who set a Universiade record in the B final, 6:39.442. But this was where the big medals were up for grabs. China with Guang Chen, bronze medalist in the 500, 1,000 and 1,500 metres going for them. It's up for Xin Guang Ma as well for China. Xin Sui and Fu Xiu their team. Powerful Russian lineup with Dmitry Myasnikov, Kirill Shashnin, Eduard Strelkov, and Timur Zakharov. The French with Thomas Melin, Juan Martinez, Jeremy Masson, and Tristan Navarro. Chinese coming to this as favourites. Japan with Dan Iwasa, Hironobu Muratake, Minto Sakai, and Hiroki Yokoyama. Number 58 in your screen, Sing Sui from the Jilin Sports University. Xinghua Ma from Changchung University, and Fuxiu from the Harbin Sports University. An impressive Chinese lineup. And they looked in control from the beginning. It's all about teamwork, coordination. Bitter disappointment for Minto Sekai, who crashed out here. And that was the end of Japan's hopes. It was down to China, Russia, and France. And the Chinese put in a consummate performance. The 56, Xinghua Ma from Changchung University. Really well executed. And the Russians and French really chasing them at this stage. Number 55, Guang Chen, looking for a fourth medal. They've all been bronze so far. Will he get a gold this time out is the big question. China in the red then, Russia in the light blue, France in the white. In the closing stages of this 5,000 metre event, with the quartet of Chen, Ma, Sui and Xu doing the job at the igloo. Number 55 taking over there, that was Guang Chen. Most experienced skater, chased by Eduard Strelkov from the Moscow State Regional Institute, Zakharov from the Bashkir State University. And that was the victory for China, coming home in 7:11.252. Fine performance for them, gold for Chen, Ma, Sui and Xu. Russia would take the silver, and a good bronze for France. 7:11.745. Well, that means South Korea finished with 5 golds, 7 silvers and 1 bronze. But China with 3 golds and 4 bronzes in the short track. Russia with 1 silver. Canada, France and Lithuania with a bronze each. China with a final gold. The curlers have been going toe-to-toe at the Fuente Nueva Pavilion in Granada, and there have been some memorable moments throughout the tournament at the Universiad. Russia won the women's event with a dramatic win against Canada, and their men, hoping to make it a memorable double, they face Norway in the final. After a disappointing Slovak leg of the Universiad, the Norwegians have been enjoying life in Spain. Kristin Asberg winning 2 golds in alpine skiing, for instance. Norway hoping the University of Oslo's curling club could give them a 5th gold medal of the Games. Could Russia deny them? Norway and Russia both went 7-2 in the group phase. There was no scoring after 3 ends. Russia went 1-0 in the 4th. Norway struck back in the 5th, though, with a deuce. Norway team skipped by Stefan Valstad of the University of Oslo, with Sander Rolvag, also from the same university. Their third is Erik Mjern from the Trøndelag University College in Trondheim. The second, Magnus Nedregotten from the Norwegian School of Sports Science in Oslo. So at halftime it was 2-1 to Norway, but the Scandinavians had a nightmare. Smart work from Evgeny Arkhipov, and Russia taking a 3 to move 4-2 ahead in the 6th end. It's a big end for the Russians, skipped by Arkhipov. Their third, Alexei Stukaleski. Second, Artur Razabov and their lead Anton Kalalb. And it was looking good for them after the sixth. Norway trailing 4-2 then. Norway had lost to Canada and the United States in the prelims. But they took a deuce in the seventh to tie the game at 4-4. More good work there from the skip, Valstad. This was to prove a very close final indeed. Going into the eighth, now Russia, remember, had edged Britain 7-5 in their semi. In the eighth, Russia took a deuce. They were 6-4 ahead, and the gold medal in sight. Norway had outclassed Russia 8-3 in the preliminaries. Russia bent on revenge. It's a real competitive match, this one. Good work from Evgeny Arkhipov. Russia taking the lead. Norway had proved too strong for their old rivals and the defending champion Sweden in the semis with a 4-1 win, but showed real guts here. Norway pulled it back to 6-5 in the ninth. And then in the 10th, repeated the trick to push this final into an extra end. Dramatic scenes at the Fuentenueva. With Norway taking a single in the ninth and the 10th to pull it back to 6-6. Relief there for Norway. They were still in it, still looking for a gold. The Russian fans urging their men on in the 11th, and Norway would win the 11th end. Russia couldn't add to the gold won by their women then, and it will be a fifth gold at the Universiade for Norway. Delight for the Scandinavians. It was now or never for Arkhipov. And this final stone. Frustration for the Russians. Delight though for Norway. They knew the victory was theirs. They just missed out on a medal 2 years ago in Trentino with Volstad in the team as a third. There was no stopping them this time. A gold medal for Volstad, Mjørn, Nedregotten and Rolvag. Russia with the silver. Britain won bronze after beating Sweden 7-4. Norway going home with the gold. Kazakhstan took on the Czech Republic with a place in the men's hockey final against Russia at stake. The Czechs started their campaign with a morale-boosting 6-3 win against rival Slovakia, then notching up victories against Spain and China. Czechs outclassed South Korea 12-0 in the quarters. The Kazakhs beat Japan narrowly in Group C before a memorable shootout win against the USA, and they beat Japan again in the quarters. The Czechs led by coach Yaroslav Liska, Kazakh coach Sergei Starigin. Czechs had Patrick Polivka in goal. His opposite number, Mikhail Smolnikov, for Kazakhstan in the blue shirts. Kazakhstan were silver medalists in Trentino, losing the final 6-2 to Canada. Czechs finished seventh 2 years ago in Italy. Early chance there for Renat Safin. Mikhail Kashulin going close as well for Kazakhstan. It was a good start for Starigin's men. Vladislav Yelikov also denied. But They would get the breakthrough. 7:49 left in the first. Alexei Antsifedov with that goal. A vital early strike then for Kazakhstan. Disappointment for Yaroslav Liska. Polivka beaten. Still in the first. Kachalin producing a good save from the Czech goalie. He was busy early on. Then on the Czech power play, Rostislav Vanek with that shot. So into the second period then, Kazakhstan with the lead. Filip Matejka with that shot. Milan Valasek with the rebound. Less than 12 to go in the second. A goal for Kazakhstan. Look at this breakaway, brilliantly done. And it was the forward Pavel Zyatkov with the finish, giving Kazakhstan a 2-0 lead. Could they hold on was the question. The Czechs had a chance. Mikhail Brzobahati. That was saved. Czechs were on a 5-on-3 power play in the second. Alexander Kurshuk and Nursultan Belgibayov off the ice. They couldn't take advantage. Jan Muller scored 3 in that easy win against South Korea, but couldn't add to his total here. More frustration it was for the Czechs. There, a Kazakh shot from German Nesterov just kept out. Coach Liska needing to find some answers in the third, but Kazakh attacks came again. Nesterov passing to Yelakov. Saved by Polivka. This shot from Antsifedov looking for another goal for him. And at the other end, the Czech defenseman Jan Skufor denied. Time running out for the Czechs. But there was to be a fabulous finish in this semi-final. A Czech goal, Petr Skolud, in the 52nd minute of play. Giving the Czechs a real chance. And a chance of a gold medal match. Kazakh had an opportunity here. Ilya Kovzalov, good save from Polivka, who made 11 saves on the day. Pavel Zyatkov couldn't quite get on the end of the rebound. For the last chance for the Czechs. Long-range effort, frustration from Muller and from Matejka. But Smolnikov made 40 saves on the day. A wonderful performance from him. And he would prove the hero. Kazakhstan through to the final, winning 2-1, earning them a ticket for that match against Russia. The Czechs can still win a medal, but need to beat Canada in the bronze medal match. And what a memorable day it was for Mikhail Smolnikov. 40 saves, getting the congratulations from his teammates, and quite right too. It was a 2-1 win for Kazakhstan, and they have the chance to beat their rivals Russia in the final. Disappointment for the Czech Republic. This one finished 2-1, 41 shots as you can see from the Czechs, but it wasn't enough. The Czechs out, Kazakhstan through to that final after a 2-1 win.
Education meets sport and culture. What best promotes excellence in mind and body? Where do friendship, integrity, and achievement meet? Which event gathers the best student athletes from around the world? The Universiade, the home of international university sports. Today's stars, tomorrow's leaders.